Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. In this video, I am going to show you how we can use 4-channel solid state relay to control 4 AC load or AC bulb using Arduino. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link which is below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. I have to warn you that working with AC is very dangerous. As soon as you connect the plug power to AC or the AC is connected here, do not touch this module, and also do not leave the module on a metallic surface or a conductive surface. Make sure it's on wood, plastic or non-conductive material. Many times you need to control AC load, and this is the best device because it doesn't have contact and you don't hear a click. For that reason, solid state relays are preferred the most. The amount of load that they can control is limited, and this shows here that it can control up to 2 ampere. If your region voltage is 120 volts, times 2, it will be 240 watts each can handle. And if you are living in Europe and Asia with a voltage of 220 volts or higher, then 220 times 2 will be 440 watts. You can control. Do not overload it, otherwise this device will die. This OMRON module, as you can see, this is made in Japan, very high quality, and they are offered in 5 volts, 15 volts, 12 volts. Here is a data sheet for G3MB solid state relay. Maximum load that it can handle is 2 ampere, and they have different variation. The one that I'm using is G3MB202P. And for this version, we will have 5 volts, 12 or 24 volts, 3 types. All of them can handle 2 ampere at 100 to 240 volts, depending on the region. I will provide this data sheet in case you need to read it further. The module is based on the OMRON G3MB solid state relay 202P. These are the series of 202P, and this is the 5 volts version, and there are 12 and 24 volts version and 15 volts, and there are different variation of those. On this side of this connector, we have positive DC, and then the negative, this will be connected to 5 volts of Arduino, this will be connected to the ground, and then it has been labeled as channel 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 4 channels from Arduino will be connected to this, and all of those from here up to here. If you don't like this type of connector, you can connect this using header type. You can use this DuPont type connector. As you can see, this is female. On the other side, we have male. So this side goes to Arduino, and this side will go in here. For each relay, we have one LED, and the LED will indicate when this is on. This LED 1 is for the first one, LED 2 is for this one, LED 3 is for this solid state relay, and LED 4 is for this SSR. And for each of this, we have a circuit here that is driving it. We have resistors and with a transistor that control and turn this on, and this makes it possible to have a high trigger or low trigger. And that solid state relay that I have is high trigger, high level, and it will be written here. When you purchase it from eBay or Amazon or AliExpress, make sure to purchase the right one that you want. The code that I've written will work for high level and low level trigger, so do not worry about this unless you have a specific technical preference. So let me explain the AC bulb here. So this is a table light fitted to the wall outlet, then the wire goes and will be turned on. But I have disconnected one of these two wires here. I've just cut this wire from here. Now this can be connected to the relay. The relay job is to just connect it, so it will be on, and disconnected will be off. I've just twisted them and then put some solder so this can be inserted into a connector with a screw. Here is the wiring diagram that I've drawn. From this side, 1, 2, 3, 4 channels. Channel 1 goes to 2, and then 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 4, and channel 4 goes to 5. On this side, The plus goes to 5 volts, the minus goes to ground in here, or you can put it in one of these two grounds here. You will connect two wires for each bulb or load that you have will be to this line. This is now disconnected from AC, so the two wires that I shown you for each load will be connected to one SSR, solid state relay, and the other two will be here, that the third one will be here, and the fourth one. So the channel starts from this side. And here, from this side, I've connected this to 5 volts of Arduino. This has been connected to the ground. And then from here, it has started from channel 1, 2, 3, and 4. And it has been connected to pin 2, 3, 4, and 5. Because we don't have pin 1, that's why it started from 2 to 5. And here it's from 1 to 4. If you don't like to use these connectors with a screw, use these headers and connect it. Let me now explain the code. We define an array of type integer, we call it SSR, and we define the pins here, pin 2, 3, 4, 5 of digital for the output to control the solid state relay. So if other pins are available for this purpose, you type something else between 2 to 13 in Arduino Uno and other pins if you're using Arduino Mega and other devices. Then we define here the trigger type. If your module is high trigger, type here high. If your module is low trigger, type here low. And everything else will be taken care of as long as you type proper high or low. This weight is, when I demonstrated, I used this time to demonstrate each channel. This is not needed, but you have to have it if you are running the code with the test. We define SSR on and SSR off. This is solid state relay on and off, which will be used next in the code as an integer type or as high and low. Inside the setup, we define the serial monitor with a 9600 baud. This is the rate that the serial monitor prints information on this screen, and that 9600 must match this number in the lower right corner of the screen. After that, we check if trigger type, this means if trigger type is high, so this is one of the shortcut or easiest way without typing equal high. This means if that is true, if the type is high, then SSR on equal high and SSR on off equal low. If the relay type that you have is low trigger, then SSR on will be low and for off it will be high. You don't worry about this, I'm just explaining it. And inside this loop, which goes from 0 to 3, 1 less than 4, we set the pins as output in this line using pin mode SSR I. This I becomes 0, 1, 2, 3, which will go and pick up these 2, 3, 4, and 5. This is as if I type 2 and then next time 3, 4, and 5, and we set each pin as an output. Then we, using this line, we set all the relays off, and this will just print this text, Robojax 4 solid state relay, once only. When we come into the loop, this is the loop, and inside the loop, we use control SSR, control solid state relay. This is a function that I have written which is below this code. I'm going to explain it, and it needs three parameters. Parameter one is number of relays, so you type either 1, 2, 3, or 4, whichever relay you want to control, and then the type of control that you want, SSR on or SSR off. And after the comma, you put the amount of time that you want to keep the SSR on. In this case, it shows 5000 millisecond or 5 seconds on. This code will run and will be executed for 5 seconds, and this line will keep that loop waiting. After that, it goes to this line, and this line is turning it off. This is just for illustration purpose, and you can change this to whatever you want, and change this to either on or off, and set the time that you want. For off, you can just even put 0, it will be off, will turn it off for you. But because this is loop, for your demonstration, I'm putting some amount of time to keep it off. But in your application, if you really need to keep it off for a certain time, put your time here. But if you just want it off, just put zero, that would be enough. And then this just shows a loop for us, that this loop, in case if you do a lot of lines and you want to make sure that know that all the items in the loop have been executed. So this is just for information purpose, and it will be printed after that one, and the second one will be executed off, and after off this will be printed, and again immediately on will be executed, as you can see. So when we pass one SSR on and 5000, this one will come and will be called number. It will become a variable called number, and SSR on will become integer type, and it will become control. And then this 5000 will be called wait, and then we check if control, this control, is equal high. Which means if you set it to on, automatically it will be high. So you don't worry, you just put SSR and capital ON. It will be high, then this code will be executed. If this control request is low, not high, this will be executed. The difference between the two is, in here, SSR on and SSR off. If that is on, if you're sent on, it will be on here, and it will be, if you're sent off, it will be off. And also we are printing this text. What does this line do is, we say digital write and SSR number minus one. The number that you're sending here, if it's one, we subtracted one, because in our relay array, this starts with 0, 0, 1, 2, 3. Because 0, 1, 2, 3 is not human friendly, I've added here minus one, because you have to just send 1, 2, or 3, or even 4. But for computer, we have to subtract it. But do not worry about this, I'm just explaining it. So this will pick up the number and we set it on. So this digital write will turn on the solid state relay, and the wait delay is the amount of wait that you sent, and it will keep it waiting. Otherwise, we use the same exact same line, except SSR off, and the same wait time that you sent. And that's it. Now I'm demonstrating it, and this is the code that 5000 millisecond on and 2000 millisecond off for this. As you can see, it's controlling only channel 1, and only the LED is on, the light goes on. Here I've changed the code. It says turn channel 2 on first, and then channel 4, and then channel 1, 2 seconds, and turn them all off, and then go back 3 seconds and 2 seconds and 2 seconds. So you can control your solid state relay like this. And here now I'm using this loop. This job of this loop is to turn 1, 2, 3, and 4 one by one, and then turn off one by one. As you can see, this one will be on now first, and then the second, third, fourth, which I don't have the bulb. And when it goes to off, this will be turned off first, and then the second one. So this LED will indicate the sequence of on and off. And here is a code. I've written a loop to go one by one. Loop goes from 0 to 3. And here we say solid state control I plus 1. The code uses human-friendly value. When you are using it, you will not be using this. You will just type your own number, so it will be easy. And this line will just say on the for loop, the relays, and this will turn off all of them. Thank you for watching. This was how to use 4 solid state relay with Arduino to control 4 AC bulb or AC load. If you like this video and learn something, please thumb up. Please also subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos. I have many videos for solid state and other relays that you can control it with push button, and use it with multiplexer, even 16 channel, 4 channel, 2, and